Tonight on Big Brother, screen stars gather.
And I don't like your type. What do you think about that?
Mate, it's the chat.
The Big Brother short film.
Barbara, darling, have you seen that hunky queer boy you've wanted?
But Sara-Marie's upset with the critics.
No, I'm not. I'm up. I don't give a I think.
There's a new rule in the Big Brother house, and the sleepyheads are about to discover it.
Big Brother thinks he's funny by turning the lights on.
Sara-Marie doesn't like it.
Big Brother has a new rule.
Yes?
Big Brother will now switch the bedroom lights on at 9:30 every morning.
Oh, no!
Housemates must not switch the lights off until 9:30 at night.
Sara-Marie's gonna hate you for that.
Yesterday's row between Blair and Anita hasn't been forgotten.
Did you get an apology?
What?
No.
Me?
Have you had one?
Hey?
Has she given you one?
No. I didn't expect one.
No, I think it was just deep. Johnny breaks the bad news about the new rule to his roommates.
Really? And Gemma told her that Big Brother said to Gemma, do you have anything to say? And Gemma said no, but I'm sure Sara-Marie will.
Did she say that?
Yeah. Yeah, but she's right there, you probably will.
Well, what can I do?
What can you do?
This morning, Sid, did you get up and turn it off?
Yeah. They're trying to make, probably trying to make nominations easier for us. I like that shirt, Danny, you know?
Thanks, baby. You're right, she ain't too happy about it.
Hey, you reckon I said anything wrong last night?
Anita?
Mm-hmm. It's the right way?
No, down. But I understand, sort of.
Yeah, no, both.
Yeah. She just doesn't know, a few weeks ago it took me a while to get used to you guys, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
So if not, I don't think it's, because we all forget that she's only been here for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
That's all. So it must be hard. Like we're all used to each other's ways.
Creeps and crips, yeah.
Yeah.
By that night, everyone's back to the scene of yesterday's altercation. And the boys are joking around with Anita again.
I'll just explain to you. With the difference that this is, are you like a water balloon? You drop it on the floor, it breaks. This doesn't. That's the whole concept of it. No, because a lot of people think that if this is thrown on the, if you throw it against the wall or it's dropped on the floor, that it will pop like a water balloon because there's water inside. It's got a whole concept about the water cools it down and all this.
With the unbreakable thing, it's unbreakable to an extent.
To an extent.
This is funny that you're taking the
I don't want any talk.
If you want to talk to me seriously, with pleasure.
Yeah, I am. Okay. It's taking the while I'm doing it. So you say unbreakable, right? So if I hold in my hand as tight as I can, it's going to break.
It's going to break, yes.
That's not unbreakable.
Yummy.
Yeah. Oh. I don't know whether to laugh or cry with you guys sometimes.
Who will be evicted from the house this week? Here's how to have your say so it makes a difference. If you want Anita to be evicted from the house, call 1902 555010. If you want her to stay, vote for either Christina or Gemma. Their numbers will be shown later in the program. Please note that call costs are 55 cents, including GST. Rates may be higher for mobile and payphones. Voting ends 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time next Sunday, the 17th of June, when final results will be released and Big Brother's 8th eviction will be shown live on 10. Next, the Big Brother film premiere.
And to Jub Jub. Nub Nub. Friends forever.
To Jub Jub.
The housemates dress up and go back to character for the premiere of this week's short film task. Ben takes on a new role as roving entertainment reporter.
What are you wearing?
Hi, tonight we have the premiere of Man Down, starring five great actors and actresses out there and a great director. My name's Billy Sherman, and tonight I'm going to bring them in for the premiere, and we'll see what the movie...
Ben, darling, thank you.
This is Anita, who played Amanda Hug and Kiss. How did you find the role, Anita?
I found it inspiring, I found it uplifting, I felt it, darling.
I had a bit of a look at the movie before, and it seemed that you were a neurotic character.
Yes.
Did you have to act like that, or were you really like that?
Yes, I'm not like that at all. I'm relaxed. I'm a relaxed person. Yes.
Okay.
I had to work very, very hard to get to that state of neuroticism. The director, Johnny, he was, wow, I love you, love you.
He was wonderful. Best director I've ever worked with. Well, I have to talk to other people. So if you don't mind sitting down, cracking open a drink. Oh, Benny, my lovely to see you. And there we had Anita, who played Miss Hug and Kiss. So did you enjoy your role? I absolutely loved it. Yes, you loved it. Yes. Now apparently you had a bit of a crush on a gentleman called Eduardo who couldn't make it tonight. He's back in Cuba.
Yes,
I loved Eduardo. You loved Eduardo, did you?
Yeah, very much so.
Okay.
Well, we had a little fling off screen, did you? Off screen, yes, we did.
Actually. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And what was it about Eduardo you liked?
He did really like Gemma after all, it was me.
Is that the truth, is it?
Yeah, really, that was the truth.
Okay, well, you look absolutely stunning in those bunny ears. If you'd like to go and sit down, get ready for the movie, and have a glass of champagne. How are you, darling?
Hi.
Come here.
Okay. Cheers.
And this is Gemma.
Hello.
And she played Sylvia in Man Down. How are you tonight, Gemma?
Oh, very, very good. Very lovely. Have you got a drink?
No, I'm fine for the moment. There's rumours going around Hollywood that you have a drug and alcohol problem.
No, pack of lies. Suing for defamation and all sorts of things. Terrible. Terrible.
Really?
Terrible things they're saying about me. It's not true.
Now, there's rumours going around the place that you happen to sleep with half the women in the show. What do you think about that? Are these true?
I don't want to say anything, mate. I'm not putting any, not stepping on any toes.
Well, mate, you know, I'm meant to be diplomatic, but you seem rather pretentious. And I don't like your type. What do you think about that?
Mate, it's the chat.
The chat?
Well, this is Jub Jub. He also stars in the film, and he has quite a pivotal role, as you'll see later.
He does. And what's one of his favourite things he likes to say? That's got his tongue, this Jub Jub fella. Can't say a word. Hasn't got a brain in his head. How can you bring along a date like that?
Oh, it's just the usual kind of guy I go out with.
Is someone strong, silent and obedient?
Yes, yes. You know, I like to tame them and just shut them up, really.
Here he is, the man we've all been waiting for, Johnny, the director of Man Down.
How are you doing?
Good, thank you, Johnny. Now, I know this was your first movie,
indeed,
but already you've been compared with the Oliver Stones, the Quentin Tarantinos and the Steven Spielbergs. What do you think about comments like that?
Well, fundamentally, I think that I would have to agree with statements like that. When people see the movie Man Down, they will in years to come think of Man Down, Titanic, and even Lawrence of Arabia in the same category, yes.
Really?
Yes.
And people have been saying the cinematography of Man Down was just unbelievable. What do you really think that is unbelievable? Because I've seen it, and it was okay, but really, it's pretty mediocre, isn't it?
Well, Ben, knowing that you don't come from the film industry, I can appreciate your rather dull statement in regards to that, but I was working with a tremendously fantastic cast and crew. Again, I'd like to... We'll wait.
Yep, all good.
...to a fantastic cast and crew. Thank you all for a tremendous
effort.
Thank you.
Good work, guys.
Thank you. Good work.
Great working.
Great working with you all.
Look forward.
And to Jub Jub. Nub Nub. Friends forever.
To Jub Jub.
To Nub Nub. Jub Jub.
To our first premiere launch.
Oh, no.
This will be at the Chop Fest.
I hate mine.
Daiquiri, please, darling. Sorry, Jackie.
See what I can whip up for you. There you go.
Thank you. Barbara, darling, have you seen that hunky poor boy Eduardo? He is hot.
I've heard he's better for much more than just cleaning pools.
I heard he's got a good reputation around here for other things as well.
Ladies, don't mean to interrupt. That guy is a sleaze. It's about the chat.
Should we swim over and speak to him?
Definitely.
Oh. It's gotta be about the chat.
Eduardo, you have a man. Can you show me what you do with your...
Well, ladies, Eduardo can do many things.
Hi, Ben, where are you going?
I'm going out for a date with Eduardo.
Eduardo the pool guy?
Yeah, of course.
Why, is there something wrong with that? No, not at all. I could kill that.
That was
excellent.
Everyone?
Cheers to everyone.
Cheers to all of us.
Cheers.
That was unreal.
Good job.
Well done.
Cheers.
To us, guys. Cool.
Cheers.
To us.
If you want Gemma to go, call 1902 555012. If you want Gemma to stay, vote for either Christina or Anita. Next on Big Brother, Sara-Marie slams her critics.
And for to make me feel like the only one that didn't pass is...
Blacklight again.
It's time for Big Brother to judge the movie and the performance of its cast and crew.
It's time to announce the results of this week's task.
Did you like our video?
Congratulations.
Did you like it, though?
Big Brother really enjoyed your presentation.
Yeah!
And your film. If you passed, your budget for next week will be $250.
If you passed?
If you failed, it will be $44.
Whoa!
Having said we enjoyed the film greatly, each housemate must score 7 or above for both creativity and contribution. On creativity, all the housemates passed with flying colours. Contribution was clearly harder for some of you. You have failed this week's task and your budget for next week is $44. Individual scores will be available in the diary room in 1 hour.
The most important element of contribution was the number of hours they devoted to the task.
Everyone tried, doesn't matter. Steve, we had fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Well done, everyone.
And you'll have plenty of food for next week, so don't worry about that. You get all new supplies on Monday.
That's a bummer.
$44 on toilet paper.
Oh, we were due to fail one.
Yeah.
It was fun anyway, we had fun.
Oh, it was great.
Everyone had a crack, who cares?
Does everybody want to know the individual scores?
Yeah, I
want to
know.
I do too.
We're in our minds, everyone contributed equally, so it doesn't matter. We all tried.
Exactly.
Certification anyway.
Well, I think everybody could, I mean, fair enough, like, some people may not have done as much on the production side, but then they had much more of a role
in the ideas. In,
or the acting side. I mean, like, for example, like with me, I was only in like 2 scenes acting, but then I did a lot of writing, so that so I thought that balanced it out. Whereas Sam, you had a lot of ideas. You didn't so much. You didn't do the writing because that's what I was doing. But then you did a lot of acting, so that I thought would balance yours out. And the same with Anita, and the same with Chrissy.
Yeah, it's pretty much out of our hands.
Yeah,
we did the best we could, and as far as food and that goes, you know, you guys will cruise through next week. You'll be fine.
You guys, we guys.
I always talk like that when I get in order.
Yeah.
I know, there's a part of me that would not like to feel responsible, but there is, unfortunately.
Why? Oh, God, no.
No, it's just the way I am.
Oh, Johnny, no way.
Responsible.
Can't feel responsible at all.
And even whoever the people were that got under the 7, we all think that everyone tried equally hard in different ways, so it doesn't matter.
out loud anyway.
Yesterday's row was fueled by Anita's fear that she would be failed for not working hard enough on the film. She's about to find out if those fears were justified.
Anita. Contribution 7, creativity 8. Contribution 7, creativity 8. Contribution 8, creativity 8. Johnny.
With passes Monday. For all the other housemates except Sara-Marie, it's time for the verdict
Tuesday,
on Director Johnny.
Contribution 10, creativity 9. Wednesday, contribution 10, creativity 9.
Excellent. So I'm the only one that's failed it then, that means.
Sara-Marie. Monday, contribution 7, creativity 8. Tuesday, contribution 7, creativity 8. Wednesday, contribution 6, creativity 8.
Well, I filed it for everyone by one point.
No, it's not.
It is. That pissed me off. It's
Steve everyone. No, it's not like that at all.
To have me make me feel like I've let the whole group down, that's what they've done. And for to make me feel like the only one that didn't pass is different if two or three people.
Oh, man, they can so stick it up that hoodie guru. I'm so wild. I'm going to bed.
If you think Christina should go from the house, call 1902-555-011. If you want her to stay, vote for either Gemma or Anita. Coming up on Big Brother, Gemma gets personal with Blair.
Do you have a problem forgiving and forgetting?
Hi, baby. I don't blame you.
I'm so fuming that it's me again. Like, not again, but I don't...
I swear to you, without a doubt, I thought it was going to be you, me, and Christina, and maybe Gemma. I thought...
But this not is, one I person, was that's so
no,
wrong.
No, 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 I would have never, ever thought in a million years. One. Do you so understand?
Wrong. Yeah, I'm not even sad, like, crying sad. I'm wild. I have a whole week of not being nominated, which I feel good about myself. Totally fine. And then, all right, if one or two people fail, but not me for yesterday. I did more yesterday than I did on Tuesday. So whoever judged me yesterday can stick it up their ass. I don't even care if saying it. I really don't.
Why should you care? Why should you care?
How embarrassing. I am embarrassed that I failed. You know, it's not even the money, the budget. It's just the fact that we all had a good time watching that movie, and then Big Brother comes on over the speaker saying we all passed with flying colours for...
creativity.
And then he says we failed the thing. No, not that. No one else failed but me. So he might as well have said, Sara-Marie, you failed for everybody.
Well, she has, you know, she's perfectly right what she's saying.
Yeah. I agree. I think she did a fair bit of work yesterday. In fact, if I can recall correctly, more than she did on Tuesday.
Yeah. Definitely was more.
There's inconsistencies in their marking. The only problem is that I remember that... I would go into the diary room and actually debate it, but it says in the rule book, Big Brother's decision is final. Yeah. In regards
it's their
to the
world,
task.
We're just living in it.
Communism.
So, I cannot believe the way I feel in here. Right now. Doesn't even feel like I'm talking, do you know what I mean? Doesn't feel like it's Sara-Marie speaking. I mean, I get angry at home, but there's for reasons. But over a stupid little task, I can't even believe I'm even worrying. But it's the fact that the way he says that we failed the second bit. No, 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 no one failed. I failed it for everybody. Not everybody failed it for everybody. I failed it. And the people that marked me f***ed up because I did more yesterday than I did on Tuesday.
No, 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 I wasn't going
to
say that.
After Anita goes to bed, the subject of forgiveness for yesterday's row is raised.
Do you have a problem forgiving and forgetting?
Mm-hmm. I appreciate the apology, but the damage is done.
Mm.
Once the damage is done. Although, you see, this is where I differ. I myself don't expect people to forgive me if the damage is done. Unless I work really hard to try and... I work for their forgiveness. I don't just expect it.
You expect it.
And that's where, if people have said something and it's me off and they apologise or they don't apologise, if they work up, you know, and just,
Yeah.
That's fine.
What about you, Ben? Do you forgive and forget?
Yes and no. If someone does something major, you're never
going to
forget it. Right. No matter what, it's only because of human memory. I'd never forget it. But if they give me a reason why, I can understand why they did it. And if I can understand that it was acceptable, which not always is.
Mm.
But I'll respect that they've, you know, come up to me and said, you know, I'm sorry for doing this and that. They've had the balls to say that. But if it was false...
apology.
Yeah. Mm. Or if it was just beyond repair, no.
But I think apologies are just such a cop-out as well. Anyone can go up and go, oh, I'm sorry.
But for someone like I find it really difficult to apologise, and not because I have trouble admitting I'm wrong, but just because I get so worked up and worried that I've hurt or upset the other person that badly that they're not going to accept my apology.
While Anita reflects on a traumatic week which saw her nominated and brought to tears, Sara-Marie is still mad at Big Brother. When the lights go on early again tomorrow morning, she'll be prepared.
G'day, Betters here. Catch more news, gossip, fighting, good loving, and the odd bit of bitching from the Big Brother house with regular updates on Triple M or read about it in the Herald Sun.
This program brought to you from Dreamworld, the home of Big Brother.